Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sneha Shetty, Clinical Director, Chief Fertility Specialist at Vriksh Fertility, HSR Layout, Bengaluru. So the field of assisted reproductive technology continues to evolve and new advances do keep growing in the field of IVF to improve the success rate of IVF. One such advances and one such new innovation is the PGT, which is Pre-Implantation Genetic Testing of the embryos. So this procedure, what we do is, there is screening of the embryos done to identify any genetic abnormalities in the embryo before the embryos are transferred into the uterus of the woman. So PGT is mainly of three types. One is PGT-A, PGT-M and PGT-SR. Now PGT-A is to rule out any kind of chromosomal aneuploidy related problems, like an extra chromosome or a missing chromosome, etc. This PGT-A will help in decreasing the chances of miscarriages and also improves your success rate. The second type is the PGT-M, which is to detect any kind of genetic abnormalities which runs in your family. So one specific genetic problem, if there is there, conditions like thalassemia, sickle cell anemia, autosomal dominant diseases like PKD, etc. Third is PGT-SR, wherein any structural relocations of the chromosomes are there that can be identified. The benefits of doing this PGT testing of the embryos before implantation or before transfer of these embryos is that, number one, by improving the success rate in IVF, by selecting good quality embryos which are free of any genetic problems. Number two is decreases the transmission of genetic disorders in the embryos, especially in conditions wherein there are certain family-run genetic problems. Number three is enhanced embryo selection. Is PGT necessary for every IVF patient? So there are certain points which we have to consider before answering this question. That is, it is a very individualized procedure which has to be done. Firstly, you have to consider the patient's age, reproductive history, any known genetic family history of any genetic problems, etc. So your fertility specialist will be able to tell you better. So it is completely individual circumstance based. Number two is with regards to the cost, financial as well as emotional burden which is there over the patient. So an additional expense in your overall IVF procedure, its limitations. We have to understand that we are taking care of the embryo part. We are ruling out any problems with relation to the embryo in order to improve the success rate, but there are certain limitations also associated with it. We do not know if there are certain other factors like your uterus endometrium related problems, etc., which are also into play with regards to your IVF success rate. So PGT is only going to help you with regards to your embryo and not with regards to other factors which help to improve your success rate. So the necessity part of it, whether it is necessary to do for every IVF patient or not, is very individualized and cannot be answered in a simple question of yes or no. It does have a lot of benefits in decreasing the chances of miscarriages and ruling out genetic problems, but other factors are also to be considered. So the final decision to undergo IVF with PGT-A should be taken with your fertility specialist by considering your age, your reproductive history, and your personal other details of your previous IVF cycle.